You're atop a city.
Well, Doris, in these early games, it's always interesting to see which teams get off to a solid start.
NBA.
Substitution on the court.
On the court for the Timberwolves. Naz Reid out there with Karl Anthony Towns. Then it's Jalen Noel. Then there's Edwards. And it's Money in at small forward. Back to Noel. To the wing, right side. Clock at six. Towns can't get it to go. Oklahoma City trailing. Here's Dort. And it's rebounded by Karl Anthony Towns. Towns has got four rebounds now.
Boy, a tough go for him in this quarter. You can see how desperately he wants to get things started. He just can't make a shot.
Oklahoma City has gone 1-2 from three-point land so far. Tipped away.
2 minutes remaining in the first.
And here we go, the Timberwolves on the run. Noel, that's good.
Noel.
And a moment here to take a look at some hustle stats for Minnesota.
I must say, their defensive intensity has been impressive so far. Really making it hard for the offense to hold on to the ball.
You know, also, they've been incredible on the fast break, taking those chances, playing with great pace. I'll tell you, you hate to pin this on one person, but his inefficiencies at the offensive end are holding this group back. Well, you think about the resurgence for Karl Anthony Towns in the 21-22 season. Selected to his third All-Star game, he actually won the three-point contest, and considering the regular season, 50, 40, 80% shooting, really sound basketball.
It's Giddey on the wing, guarded by Edwards. Down to five on the shot clock, and the three-pointer goes. So Dort's got 6 points.
Being ready on the catch, such an important skill, and Luke Dort's confidence really starting to grow.
And for Towns, team success was the biggest change for him in that 2021-22 season.
It was, B.A., because when you consider out of his first 7 seasons in the league, it's only the second time his team finished with a winning record. But Towns is looking to make that a regular occurrence from this point forward. Well, it hasn't been the most efficient game for this guy, but their team is fortunate to still be out in front.
It misses. Had a chance to tie it.
Boy, a really tough quarter for this guy. Just struggling to make shots right now.
Pass to Reid. Up top, Edwards. The teardrop. And it's Giddey with a rebound. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot two.
Listen, he's going to get stronger, but you talk about guile and the willingness to battle down low. Josh Giddey is more than up to the task.
And he's good on the second. Outside, Anderson. That'll count. No good. Misses at the buzzer. And that concludes a back-and-forth, high-scoring first quarter of play. The T-Wolves on top.
18.
Ladies and gentlemen, your Thunder, you can't be.
Step forward last season, finishing their highest conference finish since 2004, made it all the way up to the 7th spot in a very competitive West.
And that one misses. Looking at the progress Minnesota has made, many think the best is yet to come, Doris.
Well, they've made smart draft acquisitions, beginning with young Mr. Anthony Edwards, a big-time talent. And obviously, you've got to grow that young talent. That's exactly how you build a bright future for your team.
So for Minnesota right now, Jalen Noel out there with Anthony Edwards.
Then it's Carl Anthony Towns. Then there's Naz Reid. And it's Money in at the small forward position. Pass to Šarić. Goes up again. And he's going to the line for two. The official saw contact while he was going up.
Personal foul.
Showing more aggression here in the second quarter. He's seeking contact and working himself to the line.
Well, Norris, Commissioner Silver has acknowledged that the style of play in today's game may have an added impact on players' bodies. How so, you think?
I think, Brian, it's not only style of play. It's the nature of an NBA schedule. You're talking 82 games over the course of several months strung together. It's going to challenge anybody physically and mentally. The wonderful part of today's science is we can have a greater understanding of that and when to rest and when to play.
There's a minute 34 left in the first half.
This guy's got tremendous length for his position, so at 6'6", Gilgeous Alexander, confident attacking in the paint.
A chance here to catch up with Allie from the sideline.
Well, guys, Shai Gilgeous-Alexander, one of the deadliest drivers in the league. Coach Nick Nurse of the Raptors said, quote, his first step is unbelievable. It's hard for anybody to keep him in front of him, and once he blows by you, he can slow down, he can sidestep. He's got a lot of things going. Brian?
Well, it's fun to watch, Allie. Thanks for that. Giddy finds Dort. Here's Edwards. Here's Towns. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take two free throws.
Beautifully done by Towns, using the up fake to bait the defender.
And the first one at the line is good. Williams has checked in for Oklahoma City. Second free throw, no good.
Yeah, and despite being the youngest team in the league, the Thunder have been solid defensively the last couple years. A great sign going forward for this franchise.
Dort against Towns. Outside for Dort. Just five on the clock. Over Towns. The shot by Dort, no good. 3 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Here's Money. Pass to Reed. Down low. Here's Towns. And he lays it up and in. Towns has got 13.
Well, the advantage they have right now is largely based on his play. What an outstanding night.
Here's Gilgeous Alexander. And he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line for a pair.
Second personal foul.
Well, the tremendous length.
About Carl Anthony Towns for the Timberwolves, hunting for opportunities, leading to 9 points in the quarter. We'll be right back.
44.
And as we get into this third quarter, as we've seen so far, neither team able to create much. So it's Oklahoma City winning this one. Even early on in this game, they appeared happy to be playing at home.
And it makes a huge difference. Once they started to get into a groove, you never really felt like they wouldn't come out on top.
And that'll do it, folks. For Allie LaForce, Doris Burke, and Grant Hill, this is Brian Hampson alongside our 2K Sports crew, thanking you for watching. So long, everyone.
impossible. The same age, but I suppose wasn't on the same page.
MP, what's up, bro?
T-Mac, man, you here to see me?
Yeah.
All right, so what'd you do to get past that?
Man, I needed to talk to someone.
From episode 35, your winner was 1F Mir with the save and the put back slam.
You know, almost every team has some kind of roster turnover in the offseason, so, Greg, this time of year can be about getting familiar with.
Substitution for Minnesota.
Naz Reid, he's checked in for Rudy Gobert. Money comes in for McDaniels. And it's Noel in for Mike Conley. Kata Bates-Diop's checked in for the Spurs. Devontae Graham comes in for Jones. On the court right now for the Spurs, sharing the wing spots, it's Vassell and Johnson. Then there's Devontae Graham. Then it's Collins. And it's Bates-Diop in at the four. Here's Johnson. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
You have to appreciate Johnson's effort there. He just stays with it and keeps coming.
San Antonio shooting their second and third free throws tonight.
And they were 75% from the line a season ago.
Looking at who's out there now for the Timberwolves. Kyle Anderson comes in for Towns. And Nikhil Alexander-Walker in for Edwards. Left side, Anderson. Knocked loose and taken away by Johnson. And the Spurs pushing it up now. They get the rebound. Great positioning on the footback.
And that one gives them a +5 rebound advantage. Kevin.
Noel passes to Money. Anderson outside.
2 minutes.
Here's Alexander Walker. And no good, his first shot of the night, missing.
Not pretty. You just got to shake off a miss like that.
Reed with the rebound. Minnesota leading by 6. It ended in the bubble, but how about the Spurs playoff streak? 22 consecutive seasons, Greg, coming to an end.
Kevin, making it every year from 1998 to 2019, winning 5 titles over that span, and having the same head coach certainly helped that streak. So did having, though, a couple Hall of Famers.
Ken Burch has checked in for Johnson. Free throw, good, Anderson.
And last year, Minnesota had a tough end to their season. In their 10th playoff appearance, they made their 9th first-round exit.
Now the pass to Birch. Right wing. Nice ball movement by San Antonio. There's the 3. The Spurs getting another chance here. And it goes down, Charles 2 points. Bassey's got his 2nd basket.
And their post play has been really solid right off the bat.
Here's Alexander Walker. Still looking for his first bucket in this one. Money passes to Anderson. Inside, just 5 to shoot. And a fast break now for the Spurs. Here's Graham, and he makes the bucket, gets the whistle, and now a 3-point play chance here for him.
Yeah, outstanding job there of taking the harm and still able to finish.
And the Timberwolves making a change here. Prince has checked in. Drives to the hoop. Money, no good.
And right from the start, Kevin, they've been pounding the glass. Most of those 50-50 balls also going their way.
Here's Bassett. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. First trip to the free throw line for him in this one. And the first one drops. Carl Anthony Towns checked in for Naz Reid. That one misses, so he goes one for two. Minnesota leading by three. Here's Money. It's Prince on the wing. Let's do Alexander Walker. And he makes good on the way.
And they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
From deep. And the last shot at the buzzer doesn't go in for it. A free-flowing first quarter. Great Wolves.
20. The Spurs. 15. Making their way on to the
and so San Antonio going with an almost entirely new group here. Here is Anderson. So with Johnson sitting on the bench, here's how the floor looks for Greg Popovich. Devin Vassell out there with Devontae Graham. And it's Bassey in at the five spot. Now here's Prince. He's tightly guarded. Five on the clock. Driving in. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line.
First personal foul. Team
hey, Richard, for a while, teams went smaller. They became quicker. Now we're seeing some teams go big, playing two, sometimes three seven-footers in the lineup. It's amazing.
Yeah, there's always a pendulum swing. Once it goes too small, then all of a sudden the pendulum swings back, and now everyone is looking for size. But you have to have size that can also stretch the floor because teams need guys that can rebound. That's what they're looking for.
That shot off. The Timberwolves go the other way with it. They've led by as much as 10. No good from the wing.
And the rebound battle split evenly thus far.
And now we've got some time to check in from the sidelines. You got for us, D.A.?
Thanks very much. Now, for 22 straight years, San Antonio made the playoffs. They haven't made the last three postseasons. And former Spur Robert Horry worries if they'll ever be relevant again, saying, I hate to say that. San Antonio is a small market. Guys just aren't going to go there. And that's a dire prediction. That's a story. A successful franchise.
Wow, no kidding, David. All right, thank you.
Well, probably a little draft in the arena tonight. He's the last guy you expect to miss the mark by that
much. Absolutely. Mike Conley's checked in for Minnesota. Offensive rebound. And the rebound paying off as they pick up two on the second chance bucket right there.
Stayed with it, and his effort is rewarded with the second chance bucket.
Prince, the pass to Anderson. Graham against Conley. Shoots over Graham, and he overshot that one, missing. Spurs trail by three. They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
Minnesota with the rebound.
They're losing because he is struggling so bad, and he has not looked comfortable all game.
Pass to Money. No good that time. And the Spurs going the other way now. Two seconds left to play in the first half. Three-pointer. There it is, his second make of the game. He's missed five.
Obviously, this guy has a talent for scoring. Able to problem solve for whatever the defense tosses at him.
Conley, the pass to Mike. To the paint, here's Reed. Birch grabs the board.
and he's usually able to score on that type of defense rather easily. Surprising to see him come away empty.
And that'll do it for the first goal. And we've got second half action for you. Thus far, a pretty evenly contested game. You know, Anthony Edwards has been exceptional here, guys.
Yeah, he's just been raining down on them from deep here. Talk about dialed in.
If I'm his teammate, I keep feeding the hot hand, especially since he's been on fire from deep also.
Fighting in at the wing, it'll be Edwards and McDaniel. Underneath in the post, Towns and Gobert. And it's Conley in at the one spot. That's Chris Finch's five as we get into the second half.
That's the line for Minnesota.
The Timberwolves secured a spot in the playoffs last season, Greg, and we enjoyed it. After they got that emotional win in the play-in game in the Twin Cities over the Clippers. What a night.
And, Kevin, you could tell it meant a lot to the players. This is a team that has struggled for so long, and by getting to the playoffs, this is a step in the right direction.
Richard, one of the greatest coaches in the history of pro basketball, a guy you played for, Greg Popovich, on March 11th, 2022, broke the all-time winningest mark for a head coach in the NBA.
And what's so special is all of those victories are coming with the Spurs. And look, I had an opportunity to apologize to Pop, because if it wasn't for me, he probably would have gotten here sooner.
I think he would say that's completely not true. But he had to be one of the great coaches you played for.
It was. My career got extended because of the things that I learned in San Antonio. If I wouldn't have had that experience with him and their coaching staff, I would never have played as long as I did.
Here's Sohan. He has five. Here's Vassell. Gobert pulls it in. Gobert has got six rebounds here tonight. Now, here's McDaniel. He's guarded by Johnson. McDaniels kicks to Towns. Here's Conley. Gobert trying to get open. McDaniels, and he converts the layup. And the Timberwolves lead by five.
And you gotta love the big bucket in the paint in this sort of a grind-it-out game.
Jones up top, over by Conley, and there's the whistle on the shot. Took the foul, shot misses. He'll be shooting two.
All the officials are all over that one.
The Spurs have made four free throws from the line and missed two.
Two shots.
Free throw missing. Hey, Richard, as soon as your playing career ended, you got right into this business, into broadcasting. When did you decide that this would be the next step?
Well, the first time is when I thought I was going to be out the league, and so I started doing more and more work until I retired in 2018. So it's...
He's checked in for the Timberwolves. Money comes in for McDaniels. Kata Bates-Diop's checked in for the Spurs. Devontae Graham comes in for Jones. Edwards finds Conley. Towns trying to get open. And Conley gets it to go. The assist from Edwards. Conley's got the lead up to 13 now for Minnesota. And that was another look at the fantastic Mobile One drive that happened a moment ago.
And the awareness of his footwork and body on that drive. Wow.
Vassell, the pass to Graham. And nothing is falling for him right now. Here's Money. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
And after a two-decade-plus playoff streak, the Spurs have been in the lottery the last three seasons, and they're focused more on youth and development.
Anderson, he's checked in for Minnesota. Richard, the Spurs with one of the youngest rosters in the league, some quality young talent that they're very excited about.
And also acquiring draft capital. And they have a history of finding some great players outside the lottery, like Tony Parker and Manu Ginobili.
You're right, they've always done it.
Yeah, you got to when you're a small market, got to invest in development.
Mm-hmm. Anderson passes to Money. Back to Anderson. Outside Edwards. Here's Money. And there's the shot clock violation. Couldn't get the shot off in time. And the Timberwolves making a change here. Hundley's checked in.
Coming onto the floor for
Spurs
Timberwolves.
Trail by 11.
Mike Hundley.
There's 1:54 left in the third quarter of the game. To the left wing, takes the three. Again, the miss by the Spurs. Minnesota's gotten the three-point bug tonight. They've taken 15 shots outside the arc. 6 of 15. Here's Johnson. Off the mark, had a chance to trim it to single digits. Timberwolves leading by 11. Right side, Conley. The 11-footer misses off the left iron.
He just looks off this quarter. Looks like he's forcing it a bit right now. A little bit in his head.
With the teardrop, and that one good. He's got 7. 109 left in the third quarter. Edwards passes to Money. Over to the left wing. Reed with it. Johnson's there. Reed kicks to Edwards. Here's the three. Rebound San Antonio.
And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they can count on him to continue missing.
Johnson, the pass to Bates Diop. Graham inside the line. They get it back. Passes it to Bates Diop. No good on the three. Timberwolves leading by 9. Here's Edwards. Takes it off the glass. Edwards got 5 points now in the quarter.
An agile move off the contact by Edwards, getting to his shot despite the difficult defense.
Graham with the bounce pass. Johnson right side.
Minnesota 5.
For San Antonio, they have shot 70% from the free throw line tonight, 7 for 10. No good on that. Minnesota winning this one easily. They imported on tonight. Dominic showing in front of a crowd that loved every minute of it.
And you know, this game could really be a defining one for what they can do when they are playing at their best. I mean, being here at home, no doubt helps. And the execution.
You were wondering, now are these in this house up to something?